Hi, in this video I will present you with a new plugin I created. It's called Multiple Sections. It will help you to create 2D sections, multiple 2D sections in the three axes with many options to control this process, like controlling the spacing between the sections, the number of sections. Also the ability to weld the vertices after the creation. Here you can delete all sections created from this script. You can select the sections. You can flip the axis. That means, for example, if the process by default starts from the bottom up in the Z direction, if you click flip, the process of creating the sections will start from top to bottom. On the Y axis it will start from back to front. Flip will force it to start from the front to bottom, and so on. Here also you have options to, for example, auto count. You just specify the spacing and the script will take care of the count. It will just calculate the volume and then decides the count for you. Here you can, in auto spacing, you can just specify the count and the script will take the whole object and divide its extent based on the axis you choose here and divide this by the number of count to decide the spacing for you. Here you have this option to offset the creation of the sections. For example, on the Z-axis, maybe you don't want the section process to start from the bottom. So you can say, for example, 0.1, then this process, the creation of the sections will start from the 10th centimeter from the bottom and then goes up. So you can offset the start of the section creation. And the three axes, of course. For now, to demonstrate this tool, I will start with a simple object and then we will use it with more complex scene. So here I have this sphere, 5 meter radius. First you need to select objects. If you don't select anything, if you click create, it will give you this warning here. So I will select the sphere. Here, let's say I want the spacing between the sections to be 40 centimeters, and I want let's say 8 sections. I will not change anything else. I will click create, and you can see here I have these sections. The script will place all sections in a group. It's called multi-sections. This will make it easy for you to just select them all at once. You can just go here and open the group and you can choose, you can select individual sections. Now if I click delete, it will be deleted. Now let's try to flip the process. On the Z-axis, I will click flip. I will keep the same values. If I click create sections, now the sections are created from top to bottom. You can see here there is nothing here because the beginning is just a tip, so there is no section. I will delete. I can do a small offset, like let's say 0.005, and click create sections. You can see here you have this small section here. I will delete. Now let's try it on another axis. Let's say the x-axis. Uncheck flip. The x-axis will start from left to right. So create sections. I will flip. Create sections, and you have those. If I press here, select sections, it will select all sections created by this script. So I have those. Delete. Let's try the y-axis. Sorry, the y-axis. So I have those. Because I choose flip, it will start from the front to back. And now from back to front. Delete. Before deleting, if I try to add an extrude modifier to this group, you can see that the shapes are opened because the vertices are not welded. So I will delete everything. I will keep the same values, but now I will keep it on the Y. I will choose this option, Weld, and you have to be careful with this tool, like I said here. If you have a very complex scene and you might end up with like tens of thousands of vertices, this process can take a long time, so I suggest you save the file before. Now, actually, I implemented an escape inside of this feature here. That means if the creation is taking too long, you can just keep pressing the escape and to stop it. And this is a progress bar for this welding process. So now I will create the sections with this option on. You can see the progress here. And then I will do the same thing with the flip option. By the way, I forgot something. I will delete this this one here. For security reasons, I made it in a way that after the weld finishes, it will revert back to unchecked. So you need to check it all the time. So create sections. So now, if I add an extrude modifier, you can have these extrusions here. Same thing for here. You have something like this. So, I will delete everything. So now let's try, let's go back, let's say for Z and try to do the same thing, but I will offset this creation by 20 centimeters. You can see here it's flipped, so it's from top to bottom. If I delete and I increase, let's say by 2 meters, you can see it's starting from here. Now let's try, of course this works for the three axes. So now let's try these options here. If you click auto spacing, you can see that the spacing is now grayed out. You can just specify the number of sections you want. On the z-axis, I will remove flip. On the z-axis, so what this does, it will calculate the extent on the z-axis and divide it by 8 here to determine the spacing between sections. So you don't have to worry about the size, the extent of the object. So now if I click create sections, you can see that it created these 8 sections for you. So I will delete this. Now if you choose auto count, the auto count, now I will put this offset to zero again. The auto count, you decide the spacing. Let's here 40 centimeters. On the z-axis, the script will start from the bottom and start creating sections with 40 centimeters spacing until the end. So if I click create spacing, create sections, you see this. I will delete, I will choose weld. And here you can decide the weld threshold. Now generally 0.001 it's enough, but I made a default smaller than this, but you can change it. I have four decimals, and by default, if you go to customize, preferences, you can choose how many decimals you have. By default, it's three. In your case, if it's three, you will see here just 0.0, so, but you can change it manually. Anyway, now they are welded, so if I click here to select the sections, if I add an extrude modifier, we'll have this. Of course, it depends on how clean the geometry is, and in some cases you might not end up with a closed spline, so the extrude will not work. So, when using the auto count, you can still use the offset option. Here, for example, it's 2 meters, the offset. With auto count, you just decide the spacing, and the script will start from 2 meters here, then calculate the extent of the object starting from this 2 meter up, if we are on the z-axis, and then create the sections like this. Now we will try the script on a real project. This is an architecture project with lots of fine details, and there's a V-Ray fur here. There's lots of details. It's a complete architecture project. So I will select all. I will keep the Z axis, and I will choose 20 centimeters as spacing between sections, and I will choose 8 for the number of sections, and click create sections. I will select the sections from here. As you can see, I have 8 sections. I will open the group. This is one of the sections. Here, for example, I have a forest pack object with two trees, and this is the path I used. Also, we'll try it with forest pack. I will keep the 20 centimeters, and maybe I will do 16 sections. I will increase the spacing. I will make it, let's say, 1.5 meters. Select the sections. I can choose, for example, a non-uniform scale, and I can make the zero, the Z zero. Okay, that's it for this video. Hope you like the script, and if you do, please press the like button, subscribe to the channel, and maybe support the channel by using the super thanks button under the video, and see you in the next tutorial. Thank you.